G'day everyone, wanted to talk to you about the latest rumours concerning the Panasonic new full-frame cameras that are going to be coming out. It's a really interesting rumour, but if you look at the announcement, it looks like Panasonic have confirmed that they're going to discuss this as a preview, I suppose, on CES on Monday for you guys. Here's the ad that's actually in the... this was sent out to their subscribers, I think. It's a newsletter that's sent out. It just says full frame without compromise. Visit us at CES 219. Got the booth number. And January the 8th to 11th. So it looks like it is going to be announced. It just says on the bottom down here that on Monday, Panasonic will have the official press conference at 10 a.m. Las Vegas time. That was in their newsletter just sent out to everyone. It's going to have the S1 and the SR1. Still unclear if it means full specs and pre-order price will be unveiled there. But things seem to be getting closer. I think initially they announced things a little bit early, I suppose just to get it out there. But it looks like now we're going to have more of an understanding what's going to come out. But if we look quickly at the specs that are still rumors at this stage, but they do look pretty amazing if you look at them. So they're saying, there's a couple of things here that worry me. It's saying on here that it's going to have contrast AF detection. And if that works like the GH5, it's not going to compete with what Sony are offering. So that's going to be a really interesting thing to see if they've been able to do some voodoo magic on that contrast detect AF. They have improved that on the GH5, but it's still nowhere near as good as what Sony's phase detection is. They're saying they're deep learning AI. Now we know that Sony are also looking at AI technology too, so this is going to be interesting to see what's incorporated here, whether it's going to do some things with exposure, you know, IAF, like Sony are announcing animal IAF and things like that. AI could also be doing things with HDR and all these other things as well. So it's going to be interesting to see what happens in that regard. A couple of great things though. It does say here that it's got body IS and lens IS. So if that's anything like what the GH5 is, it's going to be amazing. Now, I'm not sure whether they're going to be able to have that as good as what the GH5 is due to that sensor size, but I suppose we'll find out shortly. If it is anything like the GH5, that's going to be amazing because in tripod mode, you can just hand hold that and it's like it literally is on a tripod. And I love that feature when I had the GH5. So if they've got that, that'd be fantastic. Highest flash synchro speeds, not sure what that means at this stage. We'll have to wait and see. Large and high resolution EVF. So it's the industry's highest precision finder, close to human vision. So that's going to be amazing. So is that going to be as good as Sony's 5.6 million dot EVF that's going to be coming out? But either way, it sounds like it's very exciting. This also looks fantastic too. Dual slot QXD and SD cards are available there. But amazingly, that they're saying that it's going to have three-axis tiltable LCD. Now, this is really offering a firing shot to Sony. You know, I've pushed all along that I wish Sony had a tiltable LCD. Well, this is going to have that. So it looks like it's fantastic in that regard. Now, there's going to be two models that's actually announced. It's going to have the SR1, and they're saying that's going to be a 47 megapixel camera or sensor. It's going to have 4K 60p, fast and accurate AF, dual IS, robust high precision high speed shutter, large high resolution EVF, double slot with QXD and SD cards, three axis tiltable screen, 100% weather sealing. Again, that's something Sony can't offer, so that's also fantastic as well. Resistance against low temperatures, so it probably will work in really high and very low temperatures as well. So that's the S1R. There's also going to be an S1, and they're saying that's going to be for next generation hybrid and photo and video creators. So that's probably going to be related more for fusion type or hybrid shooters. So you'll probably find the low light will be better on that for video and stills due to the fact that it's probably, well, it is going to be that 24 megapixel sensor. So it's going to be interesting to see how both of these come up, but how exciting. I'm really excited. I really hope this camera pushes Sony. Like I said, we're still waiting on Sony to release their A7000 and the A7S III. But if Panasonic announced this camera, and it seems to be, if those specs alone are true, it looks like it's going to be a pretty amazing release. There's things we still have to wait and see, though, like how does that contrast detect autofocus work? How will that work, you know, in low light and in good lighting as compared to, say, when you're using the Sony cameras? Like I said to you, I did own a GH5, and I was a little bit disappointed with the autofocus in that. So let me know whether this excites you. Obviously, we're going to hear about this only in a couple of days, so can't wait. But again, like I've said to you all before, competition is great for our industry, and I hope Panasonic really does amazing things here. It certainly seems to be that this is a much better release than what Canon and Nikon have announced, if those specifications are true. The reason why I say that is because of the fact that it has an articulating screen, which the Canon has, but then the Canon autofocus basically sucks, and you have that ridiculous crop factor that's on that camera. The Nikon actually is a good release, apart from the fact that the autofocus is not good when you're dealing with low light in video in AFC. And plus, it only has one card in it. The Canon only has one card. This Panasonic has dual cards in it, which, again, I've said to you, is so important if you're dealing with professional work. So anyway, let me know what you think about it all. I think it's quite exciting. I hope they do a fantastic job. Pricing has still got to be determined yet. So we'll have to wait and see also how they price this. So interesting times anyway. So let me know your thoughts down below. See you guys.